NASA's Artemis 1 mission is poised to take a key step toward returning humans to the moon after a half-century hiatus. The launch was scheduled for the morning of August 29, 2022, but was postponed due to an issue with one of the rocket's engines. NASA will try again Friday, September 2nd, or Monday, September 5th. If these fail, then the next launch try would likely be in October. The spacecraft is scheduled to travel to the moon, deploy some small satellites, and then settle into orbit. NASA aims to practice operating the spacecraft, test the condition crews will experience on and around the moon, and assure everyone that the spacecraft and any occupants can safely return to Earth. Artemis 1 is going to be the first flight of the new space launch system. This is a heavy lift vehicle, as NASA refers to it. It will be the most powerful rocket engine ever flown to space, even more powerful than Apollo's Saturn V system that took astronauts to the moon in the 1960s and 70s. It's a new type of rocket system because it has both a combination of liquid oxygen and hydrogen main engines, and two strap-on solid rocket boosters derived from the space shuttle. It's really a hybrid between the space shuttle and Apollo's Saturn V rocket. Testing is very important because the Orion crew capsule is going to be getting a real workout. It will be in the space environment of the moon, a high radiation environment, for a month. And very importantly, it will be testing the heat shield, which protects the capsule and its occupants when it comes back to the Earth at 25,000 miles per hour. This will be the fastest capsule re-entry since Apollo, so it's very important that the heat shield function well. This mission is also going to carry a series of small satellites that will be placed in orbit of the moon. Those will do some useful precursor science, everything from looking further into the permanently shadowed craters where scientists think there's water, to just doing more measurements of the radiation environment, seeing what the effects will be on humans for long-term exposure. The mission is a first step toward Artemis 3, which is going to result in the first human missions to the moon in the 21st century, and the first since 1972. Artemis 1 is an uncrewed test flight. Artemis 2, which is scheduled to launch a few years after that, will have astronauts on board. It too will be an orbital mission, very much like Apollo 8, which circled the moon and came back home. The astronauts will spend a longer time orbiting the moon and will test everything with a human crew. And finally, that will lead to a journey to the surface of the moon in which Artemis 3, sometime mid-decade, will rendezvous with the SpaceX Starship and transfer crew. Orion will remain in orbit, and the lunar Starship will take the astronauts to the surface. They will go to the south pole of the moon to look at an area scientists haven't explored before, to investigate the water ice there. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.